South African rapper Kaspar Unyoves, who spoke to American radio personality Old Man Ebro. The hip-hop world got yet another shocking revelation as the rapper confirmed he got the Rona, which is coronavirus, of course. According to the rapper, at first, it was just a scary part where he didn't know what was going on, but he stayed home and then he started training to prepare for a boxing match between himself and AKA, of course, who are trying to sort out their beef in the boxing ring. The training was so hectic, and just at the peak of the fitness, I contracted COVID-19. This is Casper speaking in a meeting, and everybody was social distancing and doing everything that we were told to do. Somehow I caught it, and if I wasn't called by the person who tested positive, then I wouldn't have known. I just had a little headache and I thought it was from something else. So I went and got tested and found out I was positive. He further said, I was isolated for 14 days and on the 17th, it was the only day when I got it challenging. I had an active fever and my body was all over the place. I was hot and cold. Probably 7 days later, I was back running in the street. First I was running, and he goes on and on and on and on. But right now it's better. And that's the most important thing. But what caught my attention was how detailed he was, you know, how he got it, how he wouldn't have known if the person who tested positive and he had contact, we didn't contact him. So it just shows you that we all have a part to play. So in as much as you're trying to save yourself and you don't really want people, or you don't want to be stigmatized, if you test positive to coronavirus, you owe everybody that you've come in contact with that duty to let them know that, hey, I met you a week ago, I met you 2 days ago, and right now I've tested positive to the virus, so can you go check yourself? It's just to help everyone around you, because you may be lucky, the next man might not be so lucky.
I like that you brought up the idea, since I've noticed that one of the cultures here with secrecy is very diabolical. I think Nigerians are secretive to a point where it's evil. When you know that there is something that concerns the other person, you rather keep it to yourself, because you don't, it's none of their business. All of a sudden, you can really mind your business and all that. So I've seen that happen so many times with COVID. Even when people start to get symptoms, I even think before you even get tested, I mean, before you get, before it's guaranteed and stuff, if you start to feel symptoms and it's looking like that, I think you should tell other people. I got a call, I've been counting the days now, it's almost like 3 weeks since I got a call, and the guy was telling me that he got in contact with somebody that is feeling symptoms. So he's not even feeling the symptoms, but he's already doing the honors of calling. I think people need to start to really look out for their brothers in that regard. Away from COVID-19, what stood out for me was the battle between AKA and Kaspar Unyoves, that they wanted to even be physical. That was very interesting. It's an interesting concept. I mean, if both of them have agreed, then it's consensual, and you can't really say it's violence. I don't know. But it was kind of a strange idea. I mean, I've always known the beef between AKA and Kaspar Unyoves, and a lot of the times you can see that this is a PR coordinated, orchestrated thing for numbers, and then sometimes you see where this is actually very personal, and their lives are really involved. But I think the way he was so open about the issue with AKA, with that man, kind of sometimes just reminds me that these people are actually human and they can actually genuinely catch feelings for their colleagues and stuff. I don't know anything about boxing. I've never really hit anyone, but I'm hoping that they feel better after that. It's kind of like a weird way. I don't know how to interact with that.
Even AKA caught the Rona as well. So yeah. I think COVID-19 helped us keep them both in check.
I guess. I think after winning COVID-19 battle, I don't think they should get in any ring again. We beat the 2020 virus.
That's not enough for you.
What stood out for me would be when he talked about what Corona has done to him. I like to talk about how this virus is different for each person. So, and that is the dangerousness for me, if there's a word like that. Like, that's what makes me scared of the virus. Because as much as you feel that you're strong enough, or you're giving yourself the right immune boosters and all, you don't know how this virus will react when you contact it on your own body. Remember he said, after getting better, when he started running, his chest, he knew that his chest was no longer the same. I remember we also talked about the lady who had to remove her womb because of coronavirus. But the good thing is she was done having her kids anyway, right? But I mean, we don't know the number of people that have had to take out things and have an ailment or a condition they have to live with for the rest of their lives because of coronavirus. So because of that, I feel like we should be more careful. You might know that you're very strong, and yes, you're very strong, but the person that will contract this disease from you or the virus from you might not be as strong as you are, and you might be aiding somebody losing their life. So let's all just be careful.
Okay.
And I'm happy that they're okay. And if they still want to go and, you know, news entertainment, we'll watch and talk about
it. So what the book, and they'll be making a lot of money out of it as well, you know. But I think I wish they could have just followed the path of our Nigerian brothers, Emma and Victor, who just wanted to do a rap battle and people were putting millions on there.
So we should take NSA conversation.
No. That's even before the NSA. You know when Willie X wanted to put like 20 million naira on a rap battle
between
the both of them.
Okay.
So I think let's do more of that, man. We don't need to get physical before we know that we're squashing beef. Mm. Do you understand?
Sometimes okay, it will be red.
I didn't see that coming. That's if Kaspar can reach his face.
He will at least one punch will reach there.
Even how? Have you seen the height difference though?
It's not that much.
It's not that much.
It's not that much.
No, it's not that much.
But I think Kaspar will be throwing jabs upwards and AK will be throwing downwards.
It's more like maybe like 45. Not like this, but like this.
Okay, so we're analyzing the fight already. But in your opinion, what do you think will win though?
The battle.
The fight.
Honestly speaking, I'm going to say AKA.
How about you?
No. It has to be Kaspar.
Kaspar is more of a street boy, you know.
The reason why I'll say AKA is because if
AKA looks like someone that will fall sick when he has the code. Like,
there's any South African that knows the colored people are the most violent.
Oh,
No shade being thrown, but they are the most violent. It is facts and period. Those people fight. Mm-hmm. It is in their system. If you find a
who is
colored
the
boy,
person here?
AKA is colored.
It's colored.
So colored is like a complete race of, well,
it's mixed though.
Yeah, colored is in South Africa. Colored is mixed people who have mixed with each other.
Oh, okay. So colored is different in South Africa. Was about
and in South Africa being mixed race. In South Africa being mixed race, being black as in is not the same thing as being colored as well. So it's a different cultures. But he's a colored guy with their accent and everything. So I would say based on that one, he might just be a lot more.
I'll be putting my money on Kaspar anyways, in terms of bars, in terms of feast, whichever way bring
bars,
it on.
If it's bars, I'll put my money on Kaspar.
Yeah, whichever way bring it on, I'm going to knock you out. That's Kaspar.
I've heard even what's it called, therapists and stuff say that controlled violence is very good. So like, they encourage people to scream really hard. Like if you step outside and scream or tell you to go and punch things, you know, like concentrated anger.
Could have.
In case you are a violent man, abuser, listen to my words. Now, before you can say I'm encouraging rubbish, concentrated anger on things that are not human can be very healthy for people. So, I mean, if it's that type of idea, I understand. But I don't know if I'm okay with people fighting each other physically because you have issues. It's a bit weird.